Ashwathi, do you watch movies on TV?
Of course.
Do you watch serials?
Of
Do you
course.
watch cricket on TV?
No,
IPL?
I don't like
Do you
cricket.
think IPL and the serials are killing adventure?
Of
People
course.
sit glued in front of the TV. They sit glued in front of Youth Express and they don't go out and do say watch I mean do carry out something more adventurous. Do you think
Yes,
that's happening?
of course, because we see serials and we want the hero and heroine and all the cast out there to
Yeah.
perform some adventure so that we can watch and enjoy
Yeah.
sitting at home peacefully. They are just cultivating such a behavior, such an attitude in the young people, very much.
These days there are lots of adventure sports, adventure tours. Are they creating the spirit of adventure in people, or is it just it's all packaged and they see what they are told to see? What
I
do you
think
think?
some beginning has to be made,
Right.
and it doesn't matter what is the source. So as long as they make a beginning in these people, I think it's pretty good. Maybe later on they'll be independent and do their own adventures.
Have you done any adventure sports, Ashwathi? Anything?
No, sir.
Nothing.
Because?
I don't.
You did. What was it?
Paragliding.
You've done paragliding. Where is it?
It is with my friend.
In Kerala,
In
outside?
Kerala only.
Okay.
It is in that Cherai Beach and all.
Okay.
So it was nice.
My daughter wanted to do bungee jumping, and I said, no way. Of course, she went and
You are
did it.
blogging. You are
I'm blogging,
blogging.
yes.
Because,
I was just scared.
Okay.
If you had a son or a daughter, would you send her out and let her be?
Yes, I would.
Bungee jumping, paragliding.
Ah, this is really one interesting thing that I wanted to ask. Now that you're back from your work, I mean, how do you feel? I mean, like, do you feel your normal life is boring, that you want to go back to what you were doing?
It's not boring, it's very hectic. And that's the reason why I want to go back.
I'll ask a question to Ashwathi. You think women are prevented by parents or society from being more adventurous than they would like to be? Is there a gender bias in all this?
Yeah, of course, there is an agenda, mainly in India and especially in Kerala, because girls are very much forced to follow some limitations. But I'm proud that I did my BA in Women's College, but there are some girls now ready to tear off all these traditions and limitations and go forward. So it is a main problem that girls are not doing such adventurous things nowadays. There are some limitations put forward by society.
Is there a gender bias? Did anybody in the Navy, a woman in the Navy, would have done this?
The numbers are very less.
Okay.
Okay, so the chances of a guy volunteering is much more than a woman volunteering.
Right.
Now, we hope that some woman, need not be from the Navy, some woman from the country steps forward and does a solo circumnavigation.
In India, one-fourth of this country live below the poverty line. For them, life is an adventure. Every day, getting the next meal is an adventure. Do you think in this, the midst of poverty, it's fair to talk about adventure sports? And
I believe
isn't life an adventure for most of us?
I believe like you know what you're talking about is that for these people, I mean, what can we say? Adventure is a luxury, maybe.
Adventure selection.
If
Oh,
you are
yes.
looking at adventure as a lifestyle, as
Right.
in Saturday, Sunday, you indulge in adventure,
Yeah.
I don't think it will be right to recommend to somebody who cannot think of a square meal.
Right, yeah.
But at the same time, if you have a person who's
Yeah.
educated and he needs to expand the possibilities in his life, I think he should indulge in weekend adventure as often as possible.
So then it's a bias, isn't it? Adventure is only for people who can afford it. Adventure is not for the poor.
Not really.
Would you recommend to the government of India or the government of Kerala to have a special fund set apart so that poor people who have young kids who want to be adventurous have the money to
No,
receive from government for
I think I
going
think
out on their
I
adventures?
think their requirements
Everybody
are
doesn't
different.
have the Indian Navy to support them.
I think the requirements are different.
Is it so?
Yes.
How much did it cost you?
Well, I can't really put a figure to it.
Yeah. 1 million?
No, my voyage per se cost us about 3 lakhs or so.
3 lakhs. But
Yes.
3 lakhs is a lot
That's
of
it.
money for many Indians.
That's it.
That's it, because I had a boat,
Mm-hmm.
which was anyway built for the first circumnavigation.
Mm-hmm.
I needed money just for my food and basic supplies, that's all.
Now, how much did the boat cost?
The boat cost about 4.25 crores when it was built.
Crores.
Yes. And the boat was built for the first circumnavigation. I'm talking
Right.
about my voyage.
Okay.
If you want to do something big, and if you're very passionate about it, the means will find you.
It will come. It will
It'll
come.
Come.
It will happen.
If you have the will, there'll be a way.
Exactly.
Exactly.
It doesn't matter whether you don't have a square meal, it doesn't matter whether you have a roof over your head or not, the means will find you.
Yeah, I'm
But
sure the government of Kerala, the Indian Navy, the Air Force,
there will be
the
somebody
government
who
of
will come out
India,
and
the
support you.
private sector will fund
Yes.
people who want
Yes.
really to do something adventurous and don't have the money for it themselves. we don't want, I mean, by, in the name of adventure, we don't want young kid jumping into a river and getting drowned. So what would you recommend, Abhilash, about safety requirements?
Kids should be introduced to something like this in a phased manner. As in, they shouldn't just get inspired and build a paper boat and then go around the world.
Right.
In my case, yeah. I could take so much risk because I had planned out everything.
Yeah.
Right?
Planning.
And tremendous amount of planning and preparation has gone into this voyage. Mm-hmm. Lincoln said, if I had to cut a tree in 8 hours, I would sharpen my axe for 6 hours. So for 3 or 3.5 years, I was doing nothing but planning and preparing myself. And it was only in the last 6 months that I went out and did the voyage, which people see. So if you want to go and jump into a river, into a sea, go ahead and do it. But plan for it in advance. What if this happens? What if that happens? What if something else goes wrong? You need to be sure as to how to respond, how you will be rescued, etc., etc.
You plan for 6 years. That is
almost three to four years.
3 to 4 years.
Yes.
Now 3 to 4 years is like 1,400, 1,500 days.
Yes.
For a voyage that is just 150 days.
Yes.
So I think that's very important. Planning is very important.
Yes.
If people want to emulate you, whatever,
yes,
crossing a river.
If I were to just sit in a boat and start off tomorrow without any preparations, it's just being foolish.
You may not come back.
Yes.
I mean, it's a dangerous thing too. So let's not. Let's
training
not
also required, I think. No?
Yes,
You've done some training through.
A lot of training.
This,
I sailed about 22,000 miles. Before I undertook this voyage of 21,000 miles.
Uh-huh.
So a lot of preparation and planning has gone into this voyage.
Abhilash, you have, in a sense, forded the biggest stream that there is in the world. You circumnavigated the Earth. What is your next goal? Do you want to climb Everest? You want to go into space? Do you want to go into the depths of the ocean? You just want to get married and settle down and have kids.
The last option is no.
No.
I'd take any one of the above.
And no, but which of the three?
I'm still deciding. I'm still deciding what to do. I have some things lined up.
Acting as a career?
No. No.
No.
No.
Right now in Trivandrum, mostly people get excitement and their adrenaline thrills by riding bikes at high speeds and doing stunts. What would you tell these people?
I think it's totally wrong. It's totally wrong. And I think they are doing it because they don't have an avenue to channel their energies. You go out into the ocean, take a boat, go sailing, you play football, you climb trees, you swim across rivers. You should channelize your energies like that. And that will lead to a level of maturity which will stop you from driving your bikes like that on the roads. I don't drive rash.
Yeah, I like to ask, what is your biggest fear?
You see, before I set off on this voyage, to convince my mother, I told her that I'll get married once I'm back.
Your nose is growing.
Yeah. So now that I'm back, my biggest fear is that she might ask me to get married.
So you have become a celebrity now. You are very famous. You have become the nation's pride. All the weeklies, newspapers, and all the channels are reporting your interviews. And you have become so famous out here. So what changes does this adventurous journey made in your life?
See, this fame and all those things, I was not expecting it first. I did not want it. I had gone out for an experience. And when I came back, the record happened to happen. So because of all this publicity, my life has become very hectic. And because it was something that I was not expecting, I was not really prepared for it.
Can you share a particular moment or most beautiful moment which you saw in this voyage?
There were many moments. I saw albatrosses, whales, dolphins, cormorants. Seeing the sun after 30 days, that itself was a very beautiful time for me. Yes.
What were you doing on New Year's Eve, 2013?
Did you
have a birth? I mean, did you have a New Year's party?
Yes, of course. Where? I had a New Year's party. I was just behind the international, just west of the international dateline, and on the New Year's Eve, I crossed the international dateline and shifted to the 1st of January 2013. But because I was on the other side of the international dateline, I had to shift the date back and I went back into the 31st of...
So you had two New Years.
Yes.
You celebrated two,
yes,
two New Years.
Lucky me.
What were you doing on Republic Day, 26th January?
Oh, I need to tell you this. Cape Horn is supposed to be the toughest and most memorable day in a sailor's life.
Cape Horn is around Chile.
The southernmost tip of South America. Yeah. And that day, the day I rounded it, it was 26th of January. Republic Day and my parents' wedding anniversary.
Oh.
And I hoisted the national flag on the boat.
Chile.
On the boat. In the boat. And possibly that was the southernmost national flag that was hoisted on that day. It was a very, very proud moment for me. And I remembered the lines from the national anthem, which said, Uchchala Jaladhitaranga, chanted by the waves of the ocean.
Mm. Abhilash, what would you tell all the young people out there who've been watching you, who've been listening to you, who've been read about what you did? What will you tell them?
I will tell them that youth is the best time to invest in yourself. Whatever you put in right now, you will harvest a lot when you grow older.
Abhilash, I think Kerala salutes you.
Thank
India
you.
Salutes you.
Thank you very much.
Adventure is something which is not really in our genes. But then there are people who have contradicted what our genes have given us and shown us that it's possible to be adventurous in spite of all the disadvantages that as a country or as a people we suffer from. It's been a very, very interesting and very useful chat with Abhilash and the three young people. Thank you so much, viewers, for watching this episode on Adventurous India, Adventurous Kerala. Be sure to be back to watch the next episode of Youth Express, same time, same place, next week.